Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing a shaving video. I don't normally shave the traditional way. Typically, I'll just use an electric razor. And as you can see, I usually let it grow for a while before I cut it off. But today, I'm going to be doing it the traditional. So, considering I don't really know what I'm doing with it, I would not use this as a tutorial. It's just meant for relaxation. So, I'll show you some of the things I'll be using today. I'm going to do it in a few stages. And first, I'm going to just start by trimming. So I'll just kind of pare it down a little bit, make it a little more manageable. And then the next step, I'll use the electric razor. And again, just getting it that much closer. And then the third step, after applying the soap and everything, is the straight razor itself. And you can see that it's a pretty big straight razor. And I don't know if it's actually meant for shaving with or if it's meant to be a prop. But it's got, I think, what should be a sharp enough edge, so give that a try. And then we have the shaving soap, and I got this at the grocery store for, I think, $10 or so. It's not, it's called a premium shave set, but yeah, it's really cheap. And this says, each premium shaving set includes a hypoallergenic deluxe shave soap with 40% moisturizers, including aloe vera and shea butter, a hand-dipped two-toned ceramic shaving bowl, and a shave brush, handmade using only the world's finest quality, 100% natural pore bristle for the ultimate in a close and comfortable shave. And so I'll show you the components of that. So we got the pore bristle brush, which is kind of a tongue twister if you say it fast. This is going to be the first time I use this, and typically I think you're supposed to kind of soak it for a little while before you do it, but we're going to skip that part and hope that it works anyways. And then this is the soap in here. I got to take that out, and there's the little ceramic bowl. Get junk mail all the time, and that's a good way to keep the hair out of everything. Just start just by trimming it down a little bit. Got myself quite a neck beard going on right now. Tends to get a little wild. Grizzly man. Also, I normally would not recommend wearing a shirt while doing this, but for the sake of modesty, I'll wear one for the video. I don't know if you can hear the hair falling on the paper, but it almost sounds like rain. So, kind of got it trimmed down. Razor. Let me just get a little more here. Okay. Let's switch over to the razor. I usually like to kind of have fun with it a little bit when I shave the beard off. So I usually kind of do different styles as I trim it down. You just gotta be careful, you don't get hair in the eye when you're using this thing. To call this style a Grover Cleveland or something, or goat and mutton. It is kind of tricky to get the sideburns to be even. I'm going to shave them down more than this, but right now the one is a lot thicker looking than the other. The Van Gogh, I think. This one is the Chicago PD. This is it. I kind of shield your eyes a little bit. It's like the buzzing noise, like kind of whining sound. I think I catch most of the stray hairs. Alright, so now I'm gonna take the brush. Water heater isn't the fastest always. Sometimes it takes a while for it to kick in. screw a little bit. It's almost like when you clean a paintbrush, just try to work it under the water. Except you're trying to get the water in instead of the paint out. This, we're gonna put a little bit of the hot water on top of this too. Again, as I say, I have no idea what I'm doing really, so I'm just hoping it's gonna work out properly. And just gonna try to work this in a little bit. Bristles, I should say, are getting coated pretty well. And I'll see if actually what I'm gonna do, get my face wet a little bit too. Just to kinda help prep. Seem to be working all that well. I don't know if it's user error. I think you also have to be careful not to get soap too wet, because it can lose effectiveness that way. best job of applying the shaving cream, but I'm gonna give it a shot here. So I'm just gonna try to do this nice and slow, because as I say, I'm not really sure about how good a blade this is. This kind of seems more or less like I could be doing this with a butter knife. So this is where we go with plan B. This thing is totally ineffective as anticipated. So go with one of these. And you'll notice that it is for women. I prefer these. I don't know why, but they seem to do a better job. And I'm kind of being redundant with the soap now, because this kind of has a built-in even cream kind of thing. Have to make goofy faces around the mouth. No mustache area. I find that for me, and probably most people, I would imagine, this is where the toughest hair is. And it's also the toughest angles. Gotta make some monkey faces. Tough to get this right here, and sometimes you end up with a little bit of darker hair left in there, so it looks like you just have a really weird mini mustache. Alright, so that pretty much does it. As I say, this is about the farthest thing from a tutorial as it could be, but hopefully it was a little relaxing. I'm gonna just wash my face. Get some of the remaining soap off of it. But as you can see, no more beard. Relatively clean shaven. Just take the towel. Shave the old-fashioned way without nicking myself up. But as I say, it'd probably help if I didn't use a butter knife. So, there we have it.